The Philippine Justice Secretary sees better case buildup practices as his agency formalizes collaborating with the police. A recent department circular mandates prosecutors should be proactive in case buildup and prevent evidence planting and fabrications. Remulla believes this will help safeguard the innocent and bring perpetrators to justice. He notes these illegal practices have no place in the administration.
Activists and human rights groups held a protest outside the Supreme Court Wednesday to oppose the application of two judges to higher judicial posts. They're challenging the application of Quezon City Regional Trial Court Branch 89 presiding judge Ceciline Burgos Villavert and Manila RTC Branch 174 presiding judge Jason Zapanta. The protesters question the integrity of both judges because of their supposed biases against activists. Burgos Villavert is seeking a Sandigan Bayan or Court of Appeals post, while Zapanta is aiming for a CA seat. According to the group Karapatan, Judge Villavert issued a search warrant that caused 76 activists to be detained arbitrarily, while Judge Zapanta issued a warrant against activists in Batangas that became a part of the so-called Bloody Sunday incident that killed 9 activists. ABS-CBN News has reached out to the two courts, but they have yet to respond. A Philippine teachers group expresses alarm over the updated rules of social media app X, formerly Twitter, which allow adult content on the platform. Our correspondent Joyce Palanzo joins us on the line with that story. Joyce.
Yes, Ron, the Alliance of Concerned Teachers, or ACT, has called on the Department of Education to embed within the public school's curriculum a comprehensive sex education to guide students. This as they express alarm over the reported changes in the rules of the social media application X, formerly Twitter, that now allow adult content. ACT NCR Union President Ruby Bernardo says this might worsen the exploitation of children online. She adds, exposure to such online content could affect the learning of students as well as distort their perspective on many things. Being a grade 10 public school teacher herself, Bernardo witnessed how many of her students aged 14 to 16 had access to sensitive materials online. Bernardo adds schools in the Philippines do not aggressively teach learners how to deal with such online content, unlike in the neighboring nations, where they use holistic approach in sex education. On Monday, Ron, Technology News and Analysis Group TechCrunch reported that the new guidelines of X explicitly permit users to share adult content as long as it is considered a consensually produced and distributed. It also noted that sexual expression, which may either be written or visual, can be a legitimate form of artistic expression. Adult content, however, will be prohibited for users identified as children as well as adult users who choose not to view it. Ron?
Thank you very much, Joyce Balancho. The Philippine Health Department now considers COVID-19 an endemic disease. Now, this means the disease is here to stay and Filipinos must learn to live with it. The declaration comes amid the emergence of new COVID variants. DOH spokesperson Albert Domingo says this won't be the last time a COVID variant will emerge. The agency is detecting an average of 319 COVID cases per day. That's significantly lower than the 1,700 average daily cases this time last year.